Hey guys, here is Dora from the Netherlands. Hey, how are you doing? Running, doing some triathlon, maybe off season. I am having my off season and unfortunately I cannot train too much, but hopefully that will also change very soon once my medical situation allows that. Now, I thought let's check what is new on the running shoe market lately. New York Marathon was last weekend. Of course, I have run it 3 years ago. This is just a super, super experience of mine. And I really hope to return in 2024 to run it again, run the New York Marathon, because that was also the last major marathon of 2022. More companies came up with some of their new super shoes. ASICS was one of them. They just introduced a few weeks ago online their new Super Blast shoe. Which will be a combination of FF Blast Plus and FF Turbo midsole foam, which I use for the new Sky Plus shoes and also for the Nova Blast 3. So that will be really a killer combination. 45mm in the heel regarding the stack height and 37.5 in the forefoot, which means an 8mm drop, which is personally my favorite. This shoe will not have a carbon fiber plate. So this will be basically the top-end training shoe from ASICS. It is expected to retail on the 1st of December, so it can be under the Christmas tree, of course, if you are celebrating Christmas. What my biggest worry is, to be honest, because I just saw the prices in the States and that was $220 USD. So I expect that here in Europe, it will be around 250 euros. And that's a lot. Because you can even buy the Nike Vapor 5 for 250 currently. So yes, for a training shoe without carbon fiber plate, this is on the pricey end. The second shoe for today on my list is from New Balance. And they also came up with a New York City Marathon colorway. I have seen only this colorway, to be honest, so far, but I'm sure that some other colorways will also come. And that's the New Balance FuelCell Supercomp Elite version 3. At least they name it version 3. Of course, it's a bit different naming conversion as it used to be. I do have the Elite version 2, which I have run the Amsterdam Marathon last year in, and that's a super comfortable carbon plated shoe. The version 3 will also be a carbon fiber plated shoe with a dual layer of FuelCell midsole foam. I can definitely say that the version 2 was really comfortable. I was not going for the personal best at that marathon. It was really enjoy the day. And I didn't have any issues with the shoe. Of course, it's not so aggressive a carbon fiber plate and not so aggressive push feeling during your gait cycle as, for example, the Vaporfly or the Alphafly. But I really enjoyed running the marathon in that shoe and also ran several other trainings in the shoe afterwards. I will put up the full review as well. So I was definitely a fan for the version 2. I'm even considering using it the coming years as a training shoe. Version 3 seems to be more aggressive how it's set up for me, because from the 8mm drop they went to a 4mm drop, which is quite a big change. I would say that I see that's the biggest change on this shoe. As mentioned, personally I'm more in a 6mm, 8mm drop as preference, so for me the 4mm is quite aggressive. I would say that I would be afraid to use this shoe for my Achilles. But of course we are different, your body setup is different, so if you like a 4mm shoe, I'm definitely sure that it's a good choice to go for. And on the price perspective, it was 230 euros previously, the version 2, and version 3 is retailing for 240 euros, so that's a 10 euro gap, which is not so big regarding how the world is going now. So that's still a realistic price point, at least the increase is realistic. If I personally have to choose, I would go for a Nike Vaporfly, because that's the shoe what is my favorite currently for marathon or half marathon race days. Regarding the weight, it's more or less the same as the version 2. And I also see that the rubber on the outsole became less. The version 2 was already not very sticky on a wet surface, so I'm a bit afraid how the version 3 is holding up. But let me know if you have already tried the shoe. Let me know in the comment box below what was your experience. As the winter is coming, and of course the weather will be more and more rainy here in the Netherlands and Europe as well, the third category is really the water resistant, the winter shield shoes. And here in this category, what I would like to really highlight is for me the Saucony Endorphin Speed 3 Run Shield version. That would be my winterized shoe version if I would purchase a new winterized shoe this winter. I haven't tried the Speed 3 yet, but that's definitely on my wish list. And I really see this winterized version as a good version. It doesn't seem to be a bulky one. The weight is more or less as the normal Speed 3 weight. For the men it's 230 grams, for women it's 205 grams. So it's still quite low on the waist side regarding that is a winterized version. I still do have the Pegasus from Nike, I think version 36 on the winterized shoe version, and I can still run plenty of kilometers in that shoe. And yeah, I'm not planning to buy this winter a second pair of Run Shield shoes. I was thinking also quite long last year after the winter sales to purchase the Speed version 2 in the winterized version, but I did not do so. So I'm not expecting also to buy this version 3. If you have any experience, just let me know in the comment box below, because I'm sure that the community can benefit from this. Now, the price perspective is again from the States, because I have not seen the shoe yet in Europe. I'm sure that it's coming in the next weeks, because yes, the weather is still very good, but I'm expecting it will be worse very soon. It's $170 in the States. So that's again, I'm expecting 190, maybe even 200 euros here in Europe. What you can see is really the prices are just going like crazy. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye.